Hello, I'm Greg with Primal Rights. One of the most common questions that I get about this TS Customs RimX build here is whether or not the 26-inch barrel negatively affects velocity. Now, I'm not sure who put the information out there that having a long barrel is a bad idea, but I happen to hold the opposite opinion. All of my very best shooting rifles have long barrels, anywhere from 26 to 28, even 30 inches. And so when you think of all of the historic target rifles like BSA Martinis, Remington 40Xs, Remington 37s, Kimber 82s, Winchester 52s, all of those rifles have long barrels. From the factory, the majority of them had 28-inch barrels. Those rifles shot amazingly well. I have a bunch of those things in my vault. They shoot great, and I've tested a lot of 16-inch, 18-inch, and 20-inch barrels, and I have never found them to be as accurate or as precise as those longer barrels. Now, I have a lot of reasons why I think this is. Part of it is due to the fact that I've seen lower extreme spreads in the velocities on longer barrels than I have on the short barrels. The short barrels tend to just have a much wider range of velocity. They don't quite have as good an extreme spread or SD as the long barrels. The long barrels seem to kind of flatten out that curve a little bit and make it so that the ammo gets a little more stabilized in terms of velocity before it exits the muzzle. Now, the bullets are coming out of the longer barrels a little bit slower, but I don't know why people view this as a bad thing. The farther away from the transonic barrier, the speed of sound that you get, within reason, when you get down around 1,000 foot per second, you start coming into the most stable muzzle velocities for subsonic bullet flight. Being up around 1,100 is, generally speaking, going to be significantly worse in terms of how that bullet's going to fly than when you get down closer to 1,000 foot per second. There was a thread on Accurate Shooter here recently where a guy said basically that 980 foot per second was the optimal muzzle velocity, but ammo manufacturers can't reliably create ammo that goes that slow and still provide the kind of consistency and accuracy characteristics that we expect from high-grade target ammo. So with that in mind, long barrels are a good thing, folks. They're not a bad thing. All of my best shooting rifles have long barrels on them. It's not to say that the 16 and 18-inch barrels don't shoot pretty good, because they shoot pretty good. But there's a difference between shooting pretty good and being able to go and win a bench rest level event with the rifle. And it's not to say that there's not some 22-inch or 20-inch barreled bench rest rifles out there that shoot good, but I've never seen a 16-inch barrel bench rest rifle that won anything. Now, maybe they're out there. Always leave room. This rimfire sport is pretty wild and chaotic, and there's a lot of things that work that people wouldn't necessarily think would work. So it's all about testing, knowing your rifle, and seeing whether or not it's actually going to work for you. And if you're happy with the level of performance that you're seeing out of a short barrel, well, then there's no reason for you to change. But the concept that the long barrels somehow provide some sort of detriment, no, that's just not a thing. It's actually the opposite. Long barrels tend to shoot better and be more precise, and therefore they're a little more forgiving of different ammo types. They are significantly easier to tune than the shorter barrels, so they lend themselves to a much higher degree of precision and accuracy than the shorter barrels do. So I brought these two rifles out here. I've got the Bergara B14R, and I've got the TS Customs RimX build with a 26-inch barrel over here, and we've got an 18-inch barrel, the carbon fiber 18-inch barrel here on the Bergara. So I just shot 20 rounds a piece through these rifles, and I'm going to stick the velocities up on your screen right now. As you can see, one of them is slower than the other, but one of them also has a significantly better velocity spread. Now, this is the exact same ammo out of the exact same box, And Lapua claims with their test rifle that they were seeing about 1,076 feet per second is what they were getting in their test rifle. And for those of you that don't know, you can take a look at the Lapua serial number here, and those first two digits over here, if you add a 3 to them, you can get the meters per second that they tested out at with this particular lot of number, with this particular lot of ammo. So you take that meters per second, then use a readily available calculator, and you can calculate how many feet per second. And this particular batch is about 1,076 is what they tested at. And you can see the Bergara on the left side of your screen and the RimX on the right side of your screen. So the velocity is there. It's apparent that one's a little quicker than the other, but that's not the complete story. The velocity spread is also an important factor. So when you're considering how to configure your rifle, what kind of barrel length you want to go with, what kind of setup you want the rifle to have, there's a lot of things to consider. And typically speaking, the longer, heavier barrels are going to be more shootable. Not just from a raw precision and accuracy standpoint, but the longer and heavier barrels are going to allow you to balance better in compromised firing positions. So when you're up on a barricade or you're poking through a window, you're shooting across a ladder, shooting on a tire or something like that, all of the different obstacles that you're going to be presented with in field shooting, the longer and heavier barrels are going to allow you to do that better just simply because of the way that they balance. Their center of gravity is significantly different, and the weight characteristics, just kind of how they handle in the hand, is going to be significantly better. Now, conversely, if you're looking for a raw hunting setup and you just want to have a plinker to go throw in the side-by-side and go shoot stuff with, there's nothing wrong with a nice lightweight carbon fiber build. You just need to know what your goals are going into it in order to set the rifle up properly.